Hello everyone, welcome to Talented Developer. In this tutorial we are going to see how a Stripe subscription works. In that we will see a Stripe subscription object. After that we will see the real-time example. So let's start with Stripe subscription object. So first of all you need a customer. So who is customer? Like customer is your buyer. That means he is going to purchase your thing, whatever you are going to sell. So for customer you need his name and email address. After that you also need to get his payment details. Either he is going to pay using credit card, debit card, or what are the other payment method. Once you have customer details, then next thing is product. So what is product? That means what you are going to sell to the customer. So here product in the sense like it is like kind of t-shirt or photo, whatever you are going to sell to that customer. Next thing is like price. So suppose you are having a product. So what will be the price of that product? So according to that you can charge to that customer, and it can be like monthly basis or yearly basis, or it can be only one time payment. Next thing is like subscription. Subscription always represent like customer is going to access your product, and for access your services you need a customer, right? So once you have a customer and once you have product details including price, after that you can go for payment method. And once the payment has been done, you can allow him to use the subscription. Next thing is like invoice. So usually invoice will be generated when it's time to bill a customer for your subscription. So invoice can contain the like list of items, tax rate, and the total amount owned by the customer. So I'm not going in detail about invoice. I will cover in next video. And after that, the payment intent. So generally payment intent is like all the attempts that is tried by customers to pay the invoice. So we will also cover this point in other video. So these are the Stripe subscription object that must be required to start the subscription for a customer. So next thing like, okay, how we can understand or how we can design our subscription flow. So for that, what you have to do? First of all, you have to model your subscription with the product and price. Like, okay, I'm going to sell this photo with this amount. So next thing is like, you have to create a sign up flow. In sign up flow, you can ask to the customer details. And after that, you have to also collect the payment information. And once you have collected everything, then you have to create subscription and charge your customer according to that. After that, you have to also handle the payment error. So during payment, there is a chance like payment will be failed or success. You have to also handle these kind of things. Once everything is perfect, after that customer can use the subscription, and you have to give an option like he can change the plan or he can cancel the subscription. Okay, let's go to the real-time example. So this is the sandbox URL that is provided by Stripe. Here you can see the first thing like they are going for sign up, and here they are asking the email details. And what is the landing page? In landing page they have mentioned like unlimited photo hosting. That means this is the website. Here you can purchase unlimited photo hosting, and you can see they have added some image also. So first of all you have to enter any email address. So I'm just going to enter any random email address. So you understand, like this is a sign up. Here you are asking the customer details. So currently they are asking only email address, and once they got the customer email address, after that they are going to describe the plan. So they have two plan, one is basic and one is premium. First plan is going to charge $5, next one is $15, and they are going to charge only monthly basis. You can create your plan accordingly, like if you want monthly or yearly. And once the user has been selected your plan, after that you have to collect the name and the card details. That means that you have to collect all the payment information with customer details. So here I am going to enter anything, whatever you need. In card details you have to enter the test card. So just enter 4242. Just enter anything like that one, okay. And here I am going to subscribe. So you understand, first of all you have already entered the email address, right? Once you enter the email address, you can see here they have created your customer ID, right? And after that you have to select any plan like $5 or $15. After that they are going to ask your first name and the payment information. So once the subscription has been activated, you can see here this is the basic plan and this is the card details. And suppose if you want to change the pricing plan, you can change. You can see here currently I am on the $5. So If you want to cancel, you can just click here, it will cancel, right? You can see here. Again, if you click, it will just load like a first page. I hope you understand how subscription flow is working. They have created a sign up flow in that they ask the payment details with the customer information, and they are also showing the product details with the price. Once the subscription has been activated, after that they give option like you can cancel or you can change the plan. Let's move to the next section, subscription lifecycle. Here I am expecting you have collected the customer details with the payment information, and now you are going to create the subscription request. So first of all, we will start with the positive. So that means the payment has been success. Once the payment has been success, after that Stripe event status will be changed. I'm not going to cover the Stripe events currently. I will cover in another video because it is very big topic. And what will be happen? The invoice status will be true. And once the invoice status will be true, that means subscription created success. And after that, subscription status will be changed like active. Invoice status will be changed like paid. That means user has been paid and the subscription is active for that user. But in worst case, suppose your payment will be failed. In that case also, the subscription request will be created, but the status will be changed. Like invoice status is false, that means his payment is failed. So in subscription request, the status will be changed like subscription status equal to incomplete and invoice status is open. Open, that means user have to pay within 23 hours. After that, subscription will be expired. Suppose if user has been paid within 23 hours, that means again it will follow this process. Again, payment status will be success and invoice status will be changed from true to paid. After 23 hours also, user did not paid the amount. So what will be happen? The invoice will be voided. Subscription status will be changed like incomplete underscore expire and invoice status is set like void. That means you cannot perform for that subscription. Again, you have to create a new subscription. I hope you understand how Stripe subscription is working. Thank you.